Hello, my name is Christian Raul, and welcome to the second part of our Shopify, Kafka, Confluent Cloud Streamsheet demo. In the first part, I showed you how we connect a Shopify demo shop to the Confluent Cloud using a gateway that we created using a cloud-based instance of Streamsheet server. And now in the second part, I would like to use the data that we have in the Shopify topic and feed a dashboard that would report real-time data from the Shopify online shop. So how can we do this? Well, basically, we have to make sure that we can connect to this Confluent cluster and get the Kafka-based data. So every time we want to connect a stream sheet to a data source, we first have to build a connector. In this case, we have the URL of the Confluent Cloud and the username password. And based on that, we create a consumer, and the consumer has the information which topic to use. So this is stored under the name Shopify K. And we go back here and we see the inbox is set up to receive the data from Shopify K on each message arrival. So every time a message arrives, the stream sheet will recalculate all the formulas on the sheet. So let's give it a quick try. If we buy something on our shop, take the Togo 2 and check out and input the user data and the information for the payment and registration, expiration date, and secret code. And we should now have the gateway running in the cloud that puts this data to Kafka, and this stream sheet is then receiving the data and will then process it on the sheet. Of course, again, I prepared the sheet, so the easier the demo will be if it goes more smoothly that way. And again, show you what I did before. I created those connections here by drag and drop operations that allow us to connect the data from the message directly to the cells of the stream sheet. And then I built this row. Basically, I'm bringing this information into a horizontal format. So here I have the link to this cell, product, it's the same. But here with timestamp, I'm using the now function, which allows us to retrieve the current date in the Excel format. And this is supposed to work as a template for our little temporary data storage. So in this scenario, we are thinking of having a real-time cockpit, which is only showing the data from maybe the last 24 hours. So we're storing the data temporarily in the stream sheet. At the end of the session, I will show you how we can also make this more persistent by using a MongoDB database, for example. But for the simplicity, we can now continue like this. And we have here, and I'll put this to full screen, a little sheet-based database. And we have, I'm just gonna delete the data here, have a clean start again. And we then have two functions here, and I'm starting with the second one. It's called StackAdd. And the idea of StackAdd is to take this data and to add it to this database as a new record. But since we could have duplicated entries from Kafka, since Shopify is continuously updating the status of the sale, so we have to make sure that if there is an existing entry, we delete this first. And so we have a stack find function, which is looking for the unique key and making sure that it is actually dropping the data that it finds, and then directly in the next step, it will create a new record. That way, as I said, we won't have duplicates. So basically, every time a new message arrives, it will be processed here, and these two functions make sure that we have an entry in the database. That's basically it, because then we can simply use the sumif function that you know all know from Excel. Allows you to go through the database and search for a certain criteria, and the criteria is just one of the arguments of this function. So in this case, it's looking for Togo 2, and it's going into the quantity column, and the same for the turnover. We have the product as a criteria for searching, and the line price as the column to do the addition. So we only have to do this once, and then we can simply take this, oops, and do a copy or operation, and we have it here. Well, right now the numbers are not updated yet, but that will happen in the next step. And now I will do a new sale. This time I'm selecting a few more products and using maybe this product here, add to cart, and can again maybe use this one here, add to cart. So I have three products now, and buying a larger quantity here. So checking out and save, enter the data, again, enter the payment details, and here we go. And now if you go on the thing, you should instantly see that it is updating the data. You can see now all those are back to zero unless those that are just been included in the sale deal. And you can also see that, of course, we now have three records here in our database. So every time you do a sale, you will get the updated information. And of course, then for making Liverpool more nicely, you could maybe place this here and this one next to it. And I'm just going to do a little bit resizing here. And now, since this is supposed to look as a dashboard, we can, for example, use the preview feature that would show this as a cockpit without the header information, stuff like this. So you have a nice cockpit, and you can also share these kind of links. Yeah, so anybody gets this. And of course, then again, if I continue shopping, of course, I would then see the updates also in this cockpit view. So that's basically how this works. And of course, you can make this more complicated using all the Excel features, but you know, as a very simple demo, this will do. And the one thing that I promise to you is that you have an alternative as opposed to storing the data in this temporary sheet database. You could also use, for example, Mongo to do this. And you can see that I had this running in the background, and the sales that we did, they are here. And basically what's been happening here, the same story, receiving the data. And there's a nice Mongo database function we can use to find and replace an existing record, which would be this one. And in order to aggregate the data, we have a stream sheet function that does this aggregation feature of Mongo using this criteria range. And at the end, it would then place the data in here. And of course, this could be extended a lot more since I think we have like 10 products or so. And again, every time we buy a new product, the list will be updated. And so what I can do is I can create, of course, again, a chart and just use this chart feature of stream sheets and just doing this here. And again, you would basically get the same as we have here. The only difference is that here we're using a temporary database, which is not persistent over days and months. And here, this would be persistent. So whatever you choose, you can see the number of formulas is actually even less if you use MongoDB. So whatever you want. But yeah, that would be basically our demo. And well, thanks again for watching. Stay tuned. And if you want, you can try this out. StreamSheets is an open source software. And we are also just in the process of starting to have a cloud-based offering. So you can contact us through the website, and you're then able to get your own instance of StreamSheets. You're happy to try out everything that you see here. Thanks a lot, and have a good time.